So hello all and welcome back. In this video, we will talk about work and energy. We were talking about work and energy. In the previous video, we have discussed about work. What is work, right? So work is defined as the product of force and displacement, right? Whenever some force is applied on an object and it gets displaced, then only then we can say that the work is done, right? So in this video, we will talk about energy, right? So energy means capacity of doing any sort of work, right? Energy is defined as the capacity of doing capacity of a body to do a work, right? That is called energy. Suppose if I am delivering this lecture, right? Or if I am recording this lecture, or if somebody is doing some work, so the capacity of doing that work is called energy, right? So there are various forms of energy. There are different types of energy. In this chapter we will study. So basically in this chapter we will study about potential energy and kinetic energy. So potential energy is the energy of an object due to its position, due to its height, right? So I'll explain later on. Next is kinetic energy is due to the velocity of an object, right? Due to its motion, the energy which occurs due to its motion is kinetic energy. Heat energy, we all know, the energy due to light. Chemical energy, due to chemicals, the energy produced by chemicals is called chemical energy. Electrical energy, electricity, we all know, these are all the electrical appliances work on electrical energy. Then light energy. Light energy is the prime source of energy from which all of us are getting energy. So that is light energy. So in this chapter we will study about potential energy and kinetic energy. Now let us talk about kinetic energy first. So kinetic energy means the energy of a body which is possessed due to its motion. The energy of a body possessed by its motion is called kinetic energy. The energy of a body possessed by its motion, or we can say due to its motion. So the energy of a body, it is the energy possessed by a body due to its motion, or by its motion, due to its motion, we can say due to its motion is called kinetic energy, right? So kinetic energy means if an object is pushed to some velocity, right? So if we have increased its velocity or decreased its velocity, that means kinetic energy is involved in it, right? So it is defined as work done. Okay, so kinetic energy formula we have to derive. So sometimes it increases, like suppose if the initial velocity is less than the final velocity, that means kinetic energy is increasing. If final velocity is less than initial velocity, that means kinetic energy is decreasing, right? So it is defined as the work done on an object to make it acquire that velocity. So kinetic energy of a moving object, of a moving object, is defined as the work done. Kinetic energy of a moving object is defined as the work done on it to make it acquire that velocity. On it to make it acquire that velocity. This is very easy concept, right? So now this is what, how we can define, this is how we can define kinetic energy. Now let us derive a formula for kinetic energy. Let an object of mass small m, right, is initially at rest, right? Now due to F force, it attains a velocity v, right? So initially the object is at rest, that means its initial velocity is zero, final velocity is v meter per second, right? फोर्स इज एफ राइट. सो वी ऑल नो दैट वर्क डन इज इक्वल टू फोर्स इनटू डिस्प्लेसमेंट. लेट इट बी फर्स्ट इक्वेशन. सो वर्क डन इज इक्वल टू फोर्स इनटू डिस्प्लेसमेंट. दिस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो. मैंने पहले वाले वीडियो में देखा था कि वर्क डन क्या होता है, फोर्स मल्टीप्लाई बाय डिस्प्लेसमेंट. अब हम देखते हैं कि वी ऑल नो दैट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, अकॉर्डिंग टू इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, थर्ड लॉ ऑफ इक्वेशन, थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, वी नो दैट वी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू यू स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए एस राइट. सो इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज जीरो राइट, एस वैल्यू वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन. सो इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज जीरो, सो दिस यू इज जीरो, सो वी कैन पुट जीरो. सो वी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू टू ए एस, और वी कैन ऑल्सो if the object is not at rest we can define kinetic energy also. Let's suppose initial velocity is u first right, the object is not at rest, its initial velocity is initially at u velocity. So its initial velocity is u, final velocity is this. So let us derive this formula first. So v square भाई हमने मान लिया कि इनिशियल वेलोसिटी जीरो नहीं है, वो तो हम एक केस बाद में कंसीडर कर ही लेंगे कि इनिशियल वेलोसिटी जीरो है तो क्या होता है. तो अगर इनिशियल वेलोसिटी जीरो नहीं है तो वी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू यू स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए एस होगा राइट. सो वी स्क्वायर माइनस यू स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू टू ए एस हो गया. तो एस की वैल्यू कितनी हो गई, वन अपॉन टू ए वी स्क्वायर माइनस यू स्क्वायर. यहाँ से हमको पता है कि एफ की वैल्यू क्या होती है, ऑल्सो फोर्स इज इक्वल टू मास इंटू एक्सेलरेशन, एफ इज इक्वल टू एम ए, हमने पढ़ा हुआ है ये भी. सो एफ इज इक्वल टू एम ए. सो यूजिंग दिस सेकेंड एंड थर्ड इक्वेशन, सो सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग सेकेंड एंड थर्ड इन फर्स्ट, सो डब्ल्यू वर्क डन बाय काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू एफ, एफ इज एम ए, एस एस इज वन बाय टू ए v square minus u square right. So a to a cancel, we can say 1 upon 2 m v square minus u square. This is work done by kinetic energy. Most of the cases we'll have initial velocity 0. So if u is 0 right, 0 meter per second, if object is at rest initially, then work done by kinetic energy will be equal to half m v square. Work done by kinetic energy will be half m v square. यहाँ पे ये u को zero रख देंगे तो ये कितना हो जाएगा, half m v square. So this is the formula for work done by kinetic energy. याद रखना है हमने कौन कौन से equations को use किया है इसमें. सबसे पहले Newton's third equation of motion हमने use करी यहाँ पे. दूसरा हमको पता work done is equal to force into displacement है, ये हमने first video में पढ़ा था इस chapter के. फिर हमको पता है फोर्स इज इक्वल टू एम ए होता है, दोनों की वैल्यू हमने सब्सटीट्यूट कर दी इसमें, सिंप्लीफाई करके वर्क डन बाय काइनेटिक एनर्जी का एक्सप्रेशन आ गया. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दिस वीडियो. इफ यू हैव नॉट वॉच्ड द फर्स्ट वीडियो यू कैन जस्ट गो एंड यू बेटर गो एंड वॉच द फर्स्ट वीडियो. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. सो थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग.